Got him. I'm on.
That is him. That is him. That is him. That is him.
And that's how you get right back in the ball game.
How could you not love this? God, it's awesome.
Making it a game, baby.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for some redfish?
Woo! Home of Louisiana redfish, right there.
One more to go with this one, fellas, and make it a competition.
We're going
to
read your scales and lock you in at $26.97. That's your winner.
Port Arthur is located 90 miles east of Houston on the Gulf Coast of Texas and is just a stone's throw away from Louisiana. This unique town is where Texas, Louisiana, and the Gulf of Mexico collide to create a wonderful culture and an amazing fishery.
Oh my God, that's a big house right there.
A full field of the best redfish tournament anglers in the country are gathered here to compete for a $50,000 grand prize and a chance to be called Elite Redfish Champion.
Welcome to the Yellowfin Elite Redfish Tournament Series. I'm your host, Pat Malone, and today I'm joined by Mystic Lubricant Pro and Lake Charles resident, Mr. Eric Root. Eric, welcome to the set.
Great to be here, Pat.
One day behind you, you know, conditions were questionable coming into this event. A lot of rain, a lot of fresh water runoff, but you got a day under your belt. Talk a little bit about today and the conditions you faced out there and what you think might finish up coming the rest of this week.
Well, you know, Pat, conditions are very tough. We've got a lot of dirty water in the area from the extensive rainfall and flooding that's gone on in the past month or so, and the wind's blowing a little bit. So, you know, conditions are real tough. The jetty bite is on a little bit, fishing in the channel, places you think that the fishing would be good under the conditions that we have. But the weather is definitely an issue.
All right, Eric, let's talk about who's doing well. Who has a chance to make that Super 7 and get a chance to fish for that $50,000 top prize? One name that stands out to me is new to the tour. It's Freddie Frederick. Never heard of him before. Got on the series late, got in this tournament, $25.99, leading it after day one. Talk about Freddie. Can he win this thing?
Well, absolutely, Pat. Freddie is a great local angler. Got on the tour this year, put together a big day one. Looks like he is in the catbird seat right now. He can do it, but the conditions. We got 40 mile an hour winds forecasted tomorrow. The area he was fishing, you never know what's gonna happen. He's fishing school and fish. All they have to do is close their mouth and swim off.
Another pro having a great week is Mississippi angler Bo Favre.
Oh, absolutely. Bo had a great day one. But Pat, don't forget about Kevin Aiken and Dwayne Estre. They turned in a spectacular performance at the Classic just a couple weeks back, and I think they might be on the same fish. You gotta watch for them.
And Hook Pro, all the way from Charleston, South Carolina, Jamie Huff is looking good too.
Yeah, Jamie, you know, he's competitive just about everywhere. But hey, don't forget about Charlie Barton. I've seen him catching some good fish in this tournament and in the Classic. Don't count him out.
Charlie Barton, Jamie Huff, Dwayne Esche, Kevin Aiken, this field is stacked with elite anglers. That's why they call it the Elite Series. But at the end of day two, there's only seven moving on, the Super 7. And we're fixing to find out now who that'll be.
We've had high water, extreme rain conditions over the last 4 weeks here. Water's been up and down. It's still off color. It's muddy. Marsh is high. Big Bay is muddy. It's going to be a tough, tough tournament for most of these anglers.
Despite tough conditions, there were several anglers who caught good limits on day one. Joining local pro Freddie Frederick atop the leaderboard is Bo Favre, Dwayne Esche, and all the way from South Carolina, Hook Pro Jamie Huff.
I've been chasing this dream my whole life. I've got a great bunch of sponsors, and I got great support from my loving wife and my family, and I'm just blessed to be here. If we can put 3, 6, or 7 pounders in the boat, that's very doable, and it should be a short period of time that we can do it in.
We got to get across this lake first. It's blowing today, and if we can get across the lake, we can get south. I mean, that's what we got to do. Hold tight and ease across, and we'll do it.
Let's review the power pole points of the game.
On the Elite Redfish Series, anglers compete head-to-head without teammates or draw partners. Anglers fish from 7 a.m. till 3 p.m. each day, with the top seven pros after 2 days of competition moving on to fish day three. Anglers are allowed to weigh in the state, creel, and size limits of redfish each day. A dead fish will carry a 3/4-pound penalty. All anglers on the Elite Redfish Series must be able to pass a truth detection test.
When you wake up and you get to see that sunrise, you know you've made it through another night. And when you're fishing in the afternoon and you get to see the sunset, you've made it through another day. I'm just trying to cover it all until I find exactly what piece of the reef they're sitting on. So the reefs have big peaks and valleys, and right there's a gut. And those fish could be sitting down in the guts, or they could be sitting up on the top. So yesterday I pulled up, and you can see this is the mark right here that I was sitting on, and then I backed up and bumped over to this mark. And this is where we're sitting today. And I was sitting here presenting the bait this way with an incoming tide, and it was sweeping across the reef. Today we're still sitting a little bit off, so we were on that mark yesterday and we're here today, but I'm still trying to cover this main section of the reef. If you can see that shading in there, that's where the reef is. You just don't know. You just got to peck at them until you can find them. There's 45 foot of water, you know, just a quarter of a mile right over there. So what happens is all the bait gets flushed up from out offshore in the jetties and it comes into the channel. And there's oyster reefs right here, and the bait fish just drift across the oyster reefs on this incoming tide. And the redfish, speckled trout, flounder, they sit on the reefs, the backside of the reefs, and they just gorge on the bait coming through here. It's just an easy meal for them. It's like a Golden Corral buffet. Oh, dadgummit! Well, that was a bite, so we're in business. I just gotta get them. I gotta get them. So what I'm doing is I keep letting line out of my reel, because what happens if I just keep it tight, the cork is just sitting there dead flat and the bait will get out from behind it. And what you want is the cork to float naturally with the bait just dragging up behind it. So I let out a little line and it just makes a little natural drift. There he is. Big fish, big fish. Oh, big, big fish. Well, I'm afraid, I don't know, that might be pretty close. So there's our legal limit right there. You can clearly see that one's an over. That's okay. That's a start. Look here, go tell your partners now. I'm gonna just take them for a little ride and I'm gonna let them go this afternoon. All right, the one's a little smaller than you, buddy. That's a blessing right there. Found a fish.
That's what we're looking for right there, baby.
Two down, one to go.
The Yellowfin Elite Redfish Series, presented by Yamaha Outboards. Also brought to you by Ameritrail Custom Boat Trailers, Frog Togs Rain Gear, The Color Spot Digital Graphics, Hook Performance Gear, and Power Pole Shallow Water Anchors. Day two of the Yellowfin Elite Redfish Series in Port Arthur, Texas is well underway. The heavy winds and difficult conditions have made it tough on several of the anglers.
Oh no!
No! No! Gummit, take it.
Day one leader, Freddie Frederick, has been struggling to catch his first keeper fish.
Everybody's fighting the same fight today, and it's just a matter of getting a couple of bites. I just, you know, we've had the one fish already, but it was an over, so I know they're here. I caught them here yesterday. We just gotta stick with it. We may make a move here in a little bit and maybe come back to this spot, but we'll see.
When conditions are tough, the competitors who have a plan to adapt to the changing situations usually fare the best.
We just made a move. First cast, missed one.
then I just caught this fish right here.
Kevin Aiken, Jimmy Lloyd.
That's what we're looking for right there, baby.
Dwayne Ashe.
Number two.
And Charlie Barton are known as run and gun sight fishermen. But in this tournament, they've had to adapt and slow their pace way down in order to catch keeper fish.
It's one of those games where you know the fish are there, but you got to change your style around a little bit, and that's what we had to do today. I like to move a lot. If I'm on the trolling motor, I'm on it hard, I'm on it fast, you know, I'm going, and I'm trying to find fish, and I'm trying to sight cast and throw at them. But today you couldn't do that. I mean, it was really tough, but in my mind, I knew the fish were in the pond, so I just had to slow down, put my poles down, and just fish, and I would fan cast an area and work it, and then I would lift my poles up, I'd move a little bit more, and I'd put my poles back down. But I knew that the right fish were there, and knowing that in your mind makes it a lot easier for you to be able to fish throughout the day.
Bo Favre started off the day in second place. Unlike Aiken, Barton, Ashe, and Lloyd, he refuses to slow down and is relying on sight fishing to make it to day three.
I'm not good with patience. I can't just sit there and pop, pop, pop. I usually gotta be moving. But the sight cast is kind of limited though, because of the wind. The wind and overcast, you get 5 minutes at a time, the sun will come out, you'll sight cast, you'll look around. Then just when you think you're about, let's go ahead and move, we can see now. Well, sun goes down, bam, you just scared two fish.
That is a good fish.
I gotta get rid of this.
Oh, it's a stud too. Stay on there. Stay on. Boom!
6 pounds, 12 ounces. First one of the day. Two more. I see a fish. I don't know where he went. I see him.
I seen that fish at the last second right there. Come up.
Come on, stay on that line. Get tight. Bigger than the last one.
Yes!
Two down, one to go.
While much of the field has started to catch fish, day one leader, Freddie Frederick, has been struggling.
Oh, there he was. Well, that felt way too heavy to miss. I missed it. That's two. I just missed two redfish. I ain't much on quitting. But it's been a tough day. I'm going to go ahead and call it. Load up my gear and strap it down. We got to go across that nasty lake. So, unfortunately, today I did not get them. It was very tough. One overfish. But, tough conditions. We'll see what happens.
Day two of the Yellowfin Elite Redfish Series in Port Arthur, Texas is winding down. Today is the make it or break it day. Only seven of the top anglers will move on to day three.
First fishing tournament.
Here we go. 41.50 on.
The big winner on day two is Kevin Aiken. He moved from fifth to first and secured his spot in the Super 7. Close on Aiken's heels is Charlie Barton. He weighed in a great bag at 22.16. He's only a few ounces behind Aiken and has just secured his spot in the Super 7. Rounding out the field is Jimmy Lloyd for third, Dwayne Ashe for fourth, Chad Billion for fifth, Jeff Steckler for sixth, and Bo Favre for seventh. Even under tough conditions, most of the anglers were able to catch good fish, It's one of the reasons that makes the Gulf Coast of Texas so special. There truly is no other place like it.
Port Arthur is a unique Texas experience. We have Cajuns rather than Cowboys. We have Gators rather than Longhorns. This is where the Gulf of Mexico meets Texas meets Louisiana. We're only 90 short miles away from Houston, where we offer culture, adventure, just a little something extra we call Lanya. Sea Rim State Park is the place to get up close and personal with nature. With acres of marshlands to explore by kayak, alligators are sure to be spotted. The park also offers miles of natural beaches and boardwalks so you can chill, cast a line from the shore and take in the birds. From Rosetta spoonbills to egrets, Port Arthur is a bird watcher's dream. With our rivers, saltwater Sabine Lake, and easy access to the Gulf of Mexico, Port Arthur is a fishing paradise. Whether you're after redfish or flounder, you're sure to take home your limit.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what keeps us coming back, right there.
Take a break from the water and get a sense of Southeast Texas heritage. The Museum of the Gulf Coast shows Jurassic to Joplin and Buccaneers to the Big Bopper. No trip to Port Arthur is complete without trying the Cajun cuisine and dancing to Zydeco music. But no matter what time of year you join us in Port Arthur, it will be laissez bon temps rouler. We let the good times roll.
Fish on. A good one right here, guys.
There he is. He's a good one, too.
Day three of the Elite Redfish Series is off to an ominous start. Evening storms and dangerous conditions have forced the elites to change launch locations.
We are shifting our launch site because of basically a small craft advisory and then some. Yesterday got extremely worse with 3-foot seas, a couple of boats getting dunked under the waves. So to make it a little safer, we're crossing over the lake itself and launching in a safer bayou, would be a good term for it, that allows us to run into a lot more interior marsh waters and protective waters.
I can't believe this. We're going to a ramp that 3/4 of us have never, ever been to.
Even with the new takeoff site, the launch is delayed due to a severe weather advisory.
Not looking good. Not looking good at all.
We deal with this all the time, especially in the spring, but if it's lightning, we'll be holding up a little bit. You know, we're literally fishing flat marsh. The highest thing out there is maybe waist high grass, and we're up 12, 15 feet in the air. So lightning, aluminum tower, me on top with a lightning stick in my hands. Not the best case scenario for me. I'm scared to death of lightning, so we'll see what happens.
This is my secret spot. I'm fishing right here, so stay tuned.
Hey, that's my spot.
Don't say nothing, but this is what we're gonna fish at today, right here.
It looks like, if everything's correct with the radar, it looks like about maybe 12 or 1 o'clock we'll be through for the rest of the day and have a clean finish to it. That's if everything stays.
After a 2-hour delay, there was a break in the weather, and it was deemed safe for the elites to head out. With the late start and changing conditions, everything's up for grabs.
Alright, we just made a run to our, I guess, plan A spot for today. We've been running through a bunch of rain, we got storms coming, the wind's kind of calm right now, you know, flooded conditions. It's going to be a little slow here this morning, I think, right off the bat. We're sticking to this game plan all day, we're not leaving it. We're going to throw a gulp and a cork, we're going to go down this edge and try to catch them. If we go down and don't catch them, you know what we're going to do? We're going to come back and do it again. These fish are here, we're just going to wait for them to start feeding. The water's really, really high right now, and it's really dirty. It's not clean, and that's actually helping us out. What it is, we're fishing a big flat off the intercoastal. And when it's low, these fish get spooked real easy. You can catch them when a barge comes by and then it slows down. But when the water's high like this, they stay up there more, you know? It doesn't bother them as much when the water sucks out, but we actually need that wind to start blowing a little bit and get a little bit of activity to really get them feeding good and let them calm down from the first morning thunderstorm that came rolling by. But It'll be interesting. It'll be interesting. We'll stick to it and we'll catch some fish before it's over. Fish on. The good one right here, guys. This is the reason why we came over here. Fish number one for today. We'll see what it is. I gotta get the troll motor shut off. We don't know how big she is, but she feels pretty good right now. I'm gonna get the net out and get it ready. Pick the troll motor up. There she is. She's a good one, guys. There she is right there. Real good one. She's gonna kick our butt when she gets up here, guys. Got her in the net, guys. Got her in the net. Pretty good fish right there. We got to measure and make sure she fits under 28. All right. Look at that. Right underneath the line. Perfect fish. Perfect fish. We're not even going to weigh her. I can guarantee you this fish is going to scales with us. This is number one. Feels like a 7.5. Two more of these. We may win this tournament. Today we had a little delay on what we was doing for us taking off. We had some lightning and some rain. So we had to wait an extra hour and a half to leave. And of course, safety's always first. And it took us 50 minutes to get to where we're at. And I'm fishing the intracoastal. And what I'm trying to do is just pop my cork and try to entice a redfish to come and eat it. There's redfish up and down this, you know, intracoastal. And throwing the popping cork, it's noisy. And what you want to do is you want to pop it and help the redfish hear it, locate it, to take it. They don't really like a lot of noise. They're very nosy. That's what I'm trying to do, aggravate them. With the weather conditions today, it's not saying it's gonna help me. I mean, none of these conditions are gonna help me. What I'm doing here versus the guys that are sight fishing, I'm not relying on the sun or the weather to predict what I'm doing. Where I'm fishing at right here is most probably about a foot, foot and a half right here. That's the bottom right here. I'm in, you know, about 3 foot of water where the boat's at. And like I said, it basically just has a very, very subtle slope. Right now I'm trying to shallow in, you know, up tight. After a while, if that don't work, I'll move out and try right up on this ledge and see if the fish are out on the ledge. Try this up tight and see if I can't produce a strike and try to figure out where they're at. Oh, there he is. Trivias of fishing here, as you can see. I wasn't ready, didn't have my net out. And I have like I said, it's not a great fish, but hey, on a day like today, you never know. That could be a $50,000 fish, you never know. We're gonna see if we can get two more.
This is all grass. And usually it's on top of the water, so that's what I tried to do with this high water was I targeted ponds that I knew that were real shallow ponds, you know, in the past, and that were hard to fish. And, you know, if you can pull in a pond and you can have, I don't know, maybe six to 10 inches of grass under the waters where you got a little water column where the fish will float up in, that's what I like. You know, and that's what we got right now. I mean, you can't really tell, but this water is really clear. It's just, if the sun came out, it'd be like a different world right here. And what I'm trying to do right now is something that I just started doing, and I don't know if that's what's doing it or not, but I'm letting this lure fall down into the grass, and I'm shaking it out of the grass. I want it to catch grass. You know, most of the time you don't want it to catch grass, you want to keep it above the grass, but now I want it to hit the grass. And I want to make some noise and pull it out of the grass and try to get a reaction bite out of a fish. So it's been working for me the last few days, so I don't know.
There he is. He's a good one, too.
Oh,
Come on, baby.
That is like freaking perfect. Actually, we're putting him in the well just because we don't have another fish, but we're gonna try to cull him because that is way too nerve-wracking to be right there. Oh, man. Whoo, did you see that? That baby is right on the line. That's so risky because if he lays out and you go in, he will not make it. As he is right now, he'll make it. If he gets weak in the well, ain't no way that fish is gonna make it. 920 is what I got him on the boga, so it's a damn good first fish, and we'll take him.
I mean, I literally could dip net both of them almost. I can't, I'm fighting two fish.
Day three of the Elite Redfish series is well underway. What started out as a volatile morning has suddenly turned into the perfect day. The clouds have parted, the sun is shining, and it's game on for the Super 7.
And that's how you get right back in the ball game.
Here, we got one, we just got the sun, and two more, and we're right back in this thing. We got the right weather for what we're doing. I see a fish right now. Hang tight. Could be a gar. It's really hard to tell in this glare. See what he does here. Here he comes, here he comes. Oh, there we go. Damn, there's two of them. The other one's trying to eat the blade off the spinner. Which normally is really cool, but see that second fish? Look at the second fish with him. He's trying to eat the blade off the spinner. Doggone it. He's still with him. There's two together. I got one of them hooked. I literally could dip net both of them almost. I can't. I'm fighting two fish. The other one keeps grabbing the blade. This is crazy. I've seen this in big schools before, but never with a single one. Oh, darn it. All right, guys, well, pretty fish, good fish. I'm gonna talk about it in a minute. I'm gonna try to catch that other one while he's all lit up. I know that other fish is right there somewhere. I mean, from the minute I had that fish on, his partner was trying to rip my blade out of that other fish's mouth. Look, here's another fish coming at us. There we go. Got him. There we go. Good fish too. How can you not love this? God, it's awesome. Come on. Oh, this grass is something else. That's two. I know it's not a lot to get excited about. All my co-anglers probably be laughing when they see that footage about me getting excited for a 4-pounder, but man, it's been a tough tournament. I'm happy to have him.
This fish is running towards the bank, so I don't think he's running from me, so I'm hoping he just hits it, and when I get closer, he'll show himself again to me. I'm not sure. Look at him, he's like undecisive the whole while. Still undecisive. Get him, to change his mind.
Change his mind, I got him to get him to change his mind. It's the second one sitting right here too.
Little heavy one there.
Get out of there, get out of the boat, get out of the boat, get out of the boat, come on. Come on. Come on into the net. Come on into the net.
That's a good call from that little one.
Yeah, I don't mind strengthening that. You just cross the grass for a little while. You all good now.
Go from a blind fishing scenario the first 2 days to a sight fishing in perfect conditions. The wind's actually perfect now. Sun's a little bit to our back left. If they come to the surface, you see them from a long way off. Got him. Damn, he looks good. Looks perfect. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. God dang, I almost knocked myself in the water. Wasn't pretty, but we got it done. Holy crap, that was exciting. But if I get another bite like that, look out, boys.
Right now I'm looking for fish because it's actually clear enough to where I could see one down there. And I'm thinking the weather's got good, they're gonna wanna come float up. You know, it's like anybody else, you know, when the weather's bad, what do? You stay in the house. When it gets good, you go up and you start going outside, look around. I'm hoping that's what's getting ready to happen. And I figured I would just get in here and get lucky and see one float up. I don't know what this is. No, he might not be too big. He just wants to knock the water right here. Come on, baby.
850. That's the winning bag right there, buddy. That's the winning bag.
You know, I think we made a real good decision on our where we fished this morning as far as running to the intercoastal between Orange and Lake Charles. Conditions changed through the day. The sun came out, the wind died. I decided to make a move and we relocated to the marsh. A lot of winning tournaments or doing well in tournaments has to do with the decisions you make.
You got it. I don't have a hook in him. I got a hook in him now. Oh, he's got me in the grass. He got me out.
This should be an upgrade right there. Oh yeah, that's him. That's him. That's him. That's the one we're looking for right there.
You got a shot at this thing, dude. Legitimate shot.
It's the final hours of day three for the Yellowfin Elite Redfish Series. This means the pressure's on. Stormy morning weather gave the day a rough start, but afternoon sunshine has turned the day into a slugfest.
Coming at you, Kevin. Coming at you hard.
Two more of those. May have a new boat.
This one's definitely fatter, you can tell, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep this one.
Just when you think it's all over, 8 pounder in the live well. Still got 2 hours of fish.
Charlie Barton has a great bag. He caught a huge fish early that's right on the line. If the fish relaxes in the live well, there's a good chance it'll be over the legal length. Day two leader, Kevin Aiken.
Oh, that's a little toad right there.
And third place, Jimmy Lloyd.
7 1/4.
Have great bags and are on the winning fish. They both need one more big upgrade to seal the deal.
I don't think it's an upgrade, but it might be. That's an upgrade, my friend. We are golden. 11th hour, baby. 205, 206. We got a shot at this thing, man. Legitimate shot.
Got him. I'm on. I'm in a bind. We got a good one on right here. Very off. This one's right in the net. That's the one we've been looking for right there, I think. I'm pretty sure that's him.
That is him, that is him, that is him.
I'm not gonna weigh that other one, but he's 9 pounds. We just made a 5 pound upgrade. We just gave ourselves the opportunity to win this tournament.
He's actually smaller than the other one. Look, we're gonna let the big one go. That's all there is to this. We're letting the big one go. We're gonna lose a pound. This fish is so close to 10 pounds, it's ridiculous. And we're gonna let him go. He is 10, a little over 10. We're trading him for a 920 because I'm nervous. Let's see. Let's see if we did the right thing. I think we did. See, that fish is never, I could never count on this fish. No. Oh my God, he's right there.
Releasing this 10-pound fish is either gonna be the best tournament decision Charlie Barton ever made, or the worst.
Don't cover his face, Dwayne. No, go up higher, go up higher. Don't cover, oh yeah, that's better. Elite Redfish Tournament Series. My name is Pat Malone, and this week is the Challenge on the Coast 2016 right here in beautiful Port Arthur, Texas. Right now, it's time to get it started. We're ready for our first angler to come up. Ladies and gentlemen, he's all the way from Mississippi. I want you to put your hands together for Mr. Bo Favre. Here we go. Let's get in there and wait. Then we're going to show it one more time. One fish, one alive. Look at this, folks. If he can only catch one, this ain't bad. It puts him in the lead. 834 on one, Texas Redfish. Put your hands together for Bo Favre. Setting in seventh place now, the total two-day weight of 3550. Mr. Jeff Steckler. Come on up here, Jeff. 2003, your new leader. Good job, son. 5.53 pounds. Put your hands together, Port Arthur. Go Bear Oil Pro, Mr. Chad Billiot. He needs 1804 to take over the check it stick hot seat of the day. Folks, he's got three fish. They're all alive, so there's no penalty. He needs 1804. 17-13, Steckler stays in the chair. Hey, grab two good fish and let's walk out front and show the folks. The Go Bear Oil Pro, Chad Billy. Hey, put your hands together for your Yamaha Pro. Mr. Dwayne, SJ, come on now. Here we go, three fish. Uh-oh, Jeff. I've been doing this a long time. These feel pretty good. They feel real good. 17-27, Jeff said they look good, and they are. That's your Yamaha Pro, Mr. Dwayne S.A. This is Jimmy Lloyd from Lumberton, Texas. Put your hands together for him.
Yeah, Jimmy!
This might be your best of the week. Three fish. He needs $14.99, coming off of $41.50. Three fish, three alive. Lock you in at $22.48, your new leader. Goodness gracious. Don't cover his face, Dwayne. No, go up higher. Go up higher. Don't cover. Oh, yeah, that's better. This is your Royal Purple Lubricants Pro, Mr. Charlie Barton. Can you put your hands together for Charlie? He's looking dead at you like he wants to show it to you.
I expect nothing less from him.
Here we go. But he needs 22 pounds. He just threw 7 in the box, didn't he?
Looked like a 7 at least.
Okay, 7. Oh. Are you kidding me? That's a 39-inch fish. Look at that. Oh, they're hard to wrestle them things. Look at it. He's got the two-handed overhand grip.
And that's not his kick.
And the third one. Ladies and gentlemen, he may have just friggin' closed the door. He may have closed the door right here. Aiken better have something, folks. This may be your hook heavy bag of the week right here. Are you ready for this? Three fish. Three alive. He needs 22.15. He doesn't have 22.15. He's got 25.10. There you go, baby. 25.10. Your Haney Boat Pro, Mr. Kevin Aiken. Put your hands together. Look at this. He's got the double overhanded,
oh my God,
double
you see that tail?
Reverse. Look at that tail. The tail looks like an alligator. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
We can tell you this. On one fish, he's got 894. Let's do the math. Two fish. Charlie Barton could be going in a way back to back. He won the last regular season event, and this is the first regular season event. All right, Charlie, get your check. Come back here. Look at this right here. Ladies and gentlemen, we have three fish. They're all three alive. There is no dead fish penalty. So, about your day on the water. Did you?
Yeah.
We're going to find out. Ladies and gentlemen, he needs 24.93. I can tell you this. He's got 24 pounds. He's got at least 24 pounds. We're going to read the scales. Three fish, three alive, and we're going to crown your Challenge on the Coast 2016 champion because he's got 24.12. That means Charlie Barton has won the event here in Port Arthur, Texas. 81-100 behind the leader. Charlie Barton, right there, your winner.
Once I lose my drive, I won't do it no more. I've been very competitive all my life. I used to surf, I used to ride bulls. I did a lot of stuff, you know, and this gets me going. I mean, in the mornings, I'm shook up. I feel like I'm gonna throw up. I'm excited, you know? And then you saw us on the boat today. I love that feeling, you know? I got the drive for it and I love it, just like everybody else does out here. That's why we do it. We have a passion for it, and boy, I mean, it gets in your skin.
Please visit us at theredfishseries.com and be sure to follow us on Facebook.